These 15 hidden iPad tricks will completely level up your iPad experience. And trust me, you'll be surprised to see how much you can get done with your iPad. Also, I'll be sharing a bonus in between. So grab your iPad and your Apple Pencil and let's dive right in. My name is Prithviraj and I create videos on productivity, tech and life. First up, did you know that we can take a screenshot just by swiping up from the bottom left corner of your screen with the Apple Pencil? Simply swipe diagonally from the bottom left corner of your iPad and boom, a screenshot appears. And do you know what's the best part? You can mark it up or even write stuff over it immediately and save it. No need for extra button combos. It's that simple. The next hack is a game changer for people with ugly handwriting like myself. We can use the scribble feature to convert our handwriting into text. Simply open your notes app of choice. You can of course use the default notes app, which is Apple Notes. Now when you write something with your Apple Pencil, your iPad will automatically convert your handwriting into typed text. This can be done across all apps like Apple Notes, iMessage or even Safari. It's perfect for those lazy moments when typing feels like too much of an effort. To enable this, open settings on your iPad and from there select Apple Pencil and make sure this option called scribble is enabled. Now open Apple Notes and go to the handwriting layout. And when the toolbar appears, you will find this pen tool out there at the start. Now with that selected, you can simply take your notes quickly by hand and it will convert it into text. It doesn't matter if your handwriting is ugly as mine, it will get the job done for you. Let's talk about the Shortcuts app. I'm surprised that not many people are actually making the most of this amazing app. When you open the Shortcuts app, it will automatically give you many suggestions based on all the apps that you have installed on your iPad. You can browse through them and pick the one you like. If you have smart home devices like Philips Hue, NanoLeaf or something like that, you can use a shortcut to toggle it on or off using that. Personally, there are two shortcuts that I use all the time. I have created the Shortcuts app widget on my home screen so that it's easier for me to toggle them. The first one opens up ChatGPT voice, as in it will directly open ChatGPT voice conversation mode where I can simply talk to ChatGPT about a problem I'm facing or simply ask a question. Also, the second shortcut that I use most of the time is really helpful while I'm planning for my day. When I click on it will directly open up my daily planner template on GoodNotes 6, and also it will open up Todoist, which is basically my task management app of choice. So now I can plan for my day on my daily planner and simultaneously create a task on Todoist on the fly. This saves so much time for me. I don't have to remember to open Todoist and note down my tasks. I can directly do this while planning for my day. And speaking of daily planning, here's the bonus tip that I promise. You can actually use your iPad as a digital planner. You can simply load up any daily planner PDF into any notes app or maybe even make one for yourself. I highly recommend that you try out daily planning. It will really help you stay more productive and accountable, and in the end, it will help you achieve all your daily goals. As by doing this, you won't have to worry about what to do next in the middle of the day. You are gonna have a clear plan laid out for you. If you're looking for a template, then you can check out my own template. It has three different views for daily, weekly, as well as monthly planning, and also two different themes for both light mode as well as dark mode. So you can pick anyone that you like and get started. I personally, of course, would be using the dark mode. And also, if you choose to get my template, then you would be directly supporting my channel, and that would mean a lot to me. If not, you can simply use a notebook or even your notes app to do this process. But do try planning your day. This will really help you check off your to-do list each day. We can create custom shortcuts when we triple press on the power button. For this to work, open your settings and from there go to accessibility settings. Now scroll down and you will find this option called accessibility shortcut. From there, we will get an entire list of shortcuts to choose from. Pick one of your choice, and now when you tap on the power button three times, we can enable features like voiceover, zoom, guided access in a few seconds. This cheeky thing can really help you speed up your workflow. This is particularly useful for enabling guided access, and I myself have set my iPad to enable guided access when I triple press on my power button. Else, you can also use it to enable the assistive touch feature. If you have the pro model, then that thing can actually help you navigate across your iPad more smoothly. And speaking of guided access, what is this thing exactly? Well, if you're handing your iPad to someone else, use this feature. It locks your iPad to only one app so that they can't snoop around. Just triple click on the power button, set a passcode, and you're good to go. Now when you hand your iPad to someone else, they can only view the app that you have opened for them. They can't really go anywhere else. I wish I knew about this feature earlier. We all know that we can do split screen multitasking on the iPad. You can simply drag and drop any app from your dock and it will create a split screen view. But did you know that you can actually multitask between three different apps together? Well, we can. There's this thing called slide over, and trust me, this can come in really handy. Simply drag and drop your app and a floating window will appear. And now simply slide it over. After that, we can access them by sliding over as the name suggests. Now imagine this. I can have my browser open on one side, my notes app on the other, and also Spotify in a floating window all at once. This is next level multitasking. Alright, if you're someone like me and you get random ideas all of a sudden, then we can simply note them down without even having to unlock our iPad. Simply double tap on the lock screen of the iPad and it will automatically open a blank note for you. This is perfect for taking quick notes and it saves so much time. Super convenient. All these shortcuts will really make it super easy for you to note things down instantly. The Spotlight search tool is very powerful. It's not just for finding apps or searching the web. We can use it to do quick calculations and even convert currency. currencies. Swipe down on your home screen, and when the Spotlight search bar pops up, start typing something like this, 100 USD to Indian rupees, and Spotlight will give you the conversion instantly. Also, you can save some time by doing calculations here. Instead of opening the calculator app, we can simply type it here in the Spotlight bar and do the calculations straight up from here. It's a much more faster way to do quick calculations instead of having to open the calculator app. And also, we are very close to hitting 100k subscribers on this channel. I would really appreciate if you could consider hitting that subscribe button. It would definitely help me out a lot. Now, we don't need those weird apps with thousands of ads just to scan a document. Forget all other third-party apps for scanning documents. Just open Apple Notes and from there, tap on the camera icon and then select this option called Scan Documents. And now you'll be able to scan your notes and docs directly inside Apple Notes. Also, your iPad will automatically crop it and enhance your scan. This will give you a clean and clear PDF. It's great for your class homework or simply organizing paperwork. And speaking of scans, need to send photos as a PDF? Well, you can do that directly from your Photos app. If you're a student, then this might be really useful for saving notes into a single PDF. And I actually wish this was there when I was a student myself. In the Photos app, select all the pictures you require and then tap on the share icon. Now you'll be able to see this option called Print. Click on that. It will open this print preview window. Now there will be another share button on the top. Again, click on that. And as you can see, it has already converted your photos into a PDF document. And now you can save it to your Files app or anywhere you like. Or you can also import your PDF into a Notes app directly if that is required. This hack is a game changer for sharing documents, as you don't have to use any third-party apps or websites for doing so. Alright, this next hack has been there for a while, but I still find that people are unaware of this one. When you're typing something and you realize that you made a typo, don't worry. Just long press on the space bar and the keyboard basically turns into a trackpad. We can now move the cursor left and right for precise movement and take the cursor exactly where we need it to be. Alright, do you have certain notes that you don't want anyone else to see? For example, I have a private note. Here I basically store my credit card info. Like, there are times when I'm working on my iPad or on my MacBook and I'm far away from my wallet and then I need to make a payment somewhere. I can simply open that notes and copy paste my credit card credentials. This thing has really helped me, to be honest. Inside Apple Notes, we can lock individual notes with a password, face ID or even touch ID. Just swipe left on the note you would like to make private and then set your password. This is great for storing sensitive info like passwords or even personal thoughts that you wouldn't want anyone else to see. The next tip is fairly simple, but it can be a total lifesaver if you have those larger iPad models like the 13-inch iPad Air or simply the iPad Pro. It can be really tough to type something on the larger iPad models, but in case you wanted to use it with one hand, then we can do that as well. Just pinch on the keyboard with two fingers and it will shrink it down into a mini version. You can then drag it wherever you want on the screen. And once you are done, pinch outward to go back to the full-size keyboard. This mini keyboard makes things really easy and convenient for multitasking, specifically when you're using your iPad with only one hand. If you're on the Apple ecosystem, this one is a lifesaver. It's universal copy. Simply copy something on your MacBook or even on your iPhone, and now you can directly paste them inside your iPad or vice versa. This thing is a pure game changer. It works seamlessly as long as you are logged into the same Apple ID. This is perfect for people like me who often have to multitask across different devices. While purchasing something from your iPad, you can simply copy the one-time password from your iPhone and then paste it on your iPad. Rather, I'll do you one better. Go to settings and open your account settings. From there, go to iCloud. Now open the option called messages and make sure this toggle called use on the iPad is enabled. Now once you have done that, you'll be able to view all your messages and OTPs on your iPad. Now when you buy something from your iPad, you won't be needing your iPhone at all. It will directly pop up the OTP on your keyboard just like on your iPhone. Super useful. You're welcome. Finally, since we're on the topic of the Apple ecosystem, there's another thing you can take the advantage of. If you're using a MacBook or an iMac, you will be able to use your iPad as a secondary display for your MacBook. With this feature called Sidecar, your iPad doubles as a second screen for your Mac. Here's how you can do that. On your Mac, go to System Settings and open this tab called Display. From there, you can simply click on that plus button and select your iPad from there. And that's pretty much it. You have extended your workspace. You can drag and drop windows and also adjust the layout as per your liking. This is great for creative workflows or multitasking. I often use this feature while editing my videos. I can have my editing software on my main display, and on my iPad, I can open my resources folder so that it's easier to drag and drop files, or even Spotify at times for changing music on the fly. Now let me share something with you that will further enhance your iPad experience. Click here on this video, and over there I have shared my favorite iPad apps, and trust me, I'm sure you'll find something useful from my top picks. See you there.